Hey guys, Rooker Press, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 M-car for Perm Career Mode. If you hear like a fan going off, that's my laptop. It's working on the antivirus. It's making sure that the computer is clean. Nothing I can do. It has to be done. You all know. I mean, in the age we live in, you can't be. You have to be sure that your stuff is safe and that it's not gonna be infected by viruses. And it'd be handy if I had the mute on, because you don't need to hear the TV as well. Because you guys can hear it anyway. You'll hear everything that I don't. If there was a way I could hear the commentary, as well. But so that you guys could but couldn't, I don't want to go for here. But don't even worry. I don't need to listen to Martin Tyler and Alan Smith for the 5 millionth time. I'll probably hear them anyway and about an hour's time, because this is being recorded just before I go to watch the Liverpool game, which is starting then. I'm in trouble finding out where they are. Or I can't seem to locate what channel their match is being shown on, but I'll find it. I've even tweeted trying to get some help from my fellow Liverpool fans. When I watched the Arsenal game, they advertised it for BT Sports 1, but it's not there. So I don't know what the deal is with that. Maybe someone fucked up and that was not supposed to be shown as a BT Sports 1. I don't know. Maybe it is on BT Sports 1. I don't know. I'll figure it out. Something. It'll be. I'll figure it out somewhere. So. I would hate not to see the game. Watching Liverpool is eventually gonna kill me, but, hey, what can you do? And I say it's gonna kill me because they're always giving us Liverpool fans near heart attacks, but he playing 50% of the match, and that's being kind, while playing fucking terrible. And they'll suddenly play fucking great. That guy's being sent off because he's fucking numb. He's the captain as well. Sliding in. Three of the four episodes I recorded yesterday and today, this is three episodes where there's been a red card. Oh, no chance for the keeper. He went the wrong way anyway, but that was top corner, not a chance. Even if he'd gone the right way, he would have had a hard time saving that. That was probably my best penalty of FIFA 17. Look at this. Boom. That is a top quality penalty. Now, I'm one up against 10 men. I like my chances of getting the victory, I'm not gonna lie.
There's good progress with this attack.
Although,
result is going to be a throw.
Well, my opponents might regroup. I made a substitution to fill that defensive hole. I'm assuming it's going to come sooner or later. Unless they did make a substitution by this pin, honestly. It doesn't look like it. They're definitely missing a body back there. Abraham makes it tune. Well, easy as you like. Just look at this. Abraham takes the ball, slots it. That is just... This kid has a cool head on. I'm calling him a kid, he's only a few years younger than me! For fuck's sake.
This is a team on top of its game. It's certainly been reflected in the results, and it's a run of victories, a massive run of victories, that they want to extend today.
Well, you look at this team and you just wonder who is capable of beating them.
I don't know what to tell you guys.
Well, they've been thwarted
here. That.
It's a sign of better things to come. Here's a chance to attack.
That's another bad foul. They're going to have no one left back there if they keep this up.
Well,
it's a yellow card. Hurt, but that guy has to be careful. Oh, and Onoma, what a header! The goals in this game are being scored very nicely.
Coming in from the right, that was so inviting. Wonderful delivery.
Great ball, great goal.
The timing was great, and the bravery to get ahead of his man.
It was some header. Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
The penalty was brilliant. The cool, calm finish of the second goal. And Onoma's header. Yo, that was like a Luis Suarez special. If any Liverpool fans remember that one against West Brom. I still don't believe he fucking did that, crazy son of a bitch. I mean that in a nice way. Well, as nice a way as you can mean it.
Will be three added minutes here.
As much as we like Suarez, he was a bit fucking mental. I mean, you don't bite people all and stuff like that and other crazy shit they did without having a few screws loose, as it were. But, he was still capable of banging goal after goal after goal. It hasn't changed the Barcelona. He still banks in goals. But then again, anyone could be getting a shit ton of goals if they play for Barcelona. I mean, when you have Messi and Neymar and all the other great players that Barcelona have supplying you, you're going to score a shit ton of goals. Without a doubt. Oh, how did that not go in? Oh, the defender got enough on it. Son of a bitch.
And it's a header. Well, the goal scored by the side.
I think that was going in anyway, but Kim is like, thank you. Is that going in? It might have gone in off the post. Or might have gone wide. It's hard to tell because he headered it in. I was like expecting him to be offside, but the scoreline changed, so I knew he wasn't offside. Normally I look at the linesman, but I couldn't see the linesman, so I have to rely on whether the scoreline changed or not, so that's another way you can tell whether you're offside or not. Unfortunately, there's no button to stop the player celebrating if they are offside. You just have to run around like fucking moron. Come on, put on the pressure. Ah, for God's sake.
Into the attacking third.
Abraham.
Gone for the through pass.
Scheidner. Ah. Oh.
We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left.
If I sound more energetic, then that's because this is being recorded. So a bit, like I said, a few hours after when I recorded last. If any of you ever decide to start up a YouTube channel, it'll take one little bit of advice. Don't record at midnight, just don't do it. Because, you know, you just won't get up the quality that you want, you'll be tired, you'll be not really paying attention, you'll be wanting to go to bed. Just, you know, if possible, wait till the morning. And if you can't, just, you know, send out a tweet or post on Facebook or Instagram or whatever social media you use. And just tell your subscriber base that, you know, the video was, you've gotten a few videos, but, you know, you're not going to get, you know, what you want, you know. It's happened to me on a few occasions. I've had to tweet out, you know, I'm going to miss this day because I didn't get the time that I needed. It's crucial that, you know, you keep your audience in the loop, you know. You got to keep them on the circle of knowing. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. But I'm still half asleep. Talking bullshit. Basically, just keep your audience informed and you should do fine. Oh. Depending on, you know, your quality and stuff like that. But, you know, that's I can't help you with that.
Well, the tackle there has led to a throw.
Quality you put out is down to you and where, you know, you're trying to make YouTube a job, or if it's like me, it's just a hobby. It's just something you're doing. Just because, you know, I have the tools at my disposal, so that's why I'm doing it. Not particularly. I don't ever, you know, plan to make YouTube a full-time job because, well, I, one, don't get, you know, I'm not ever going to rake in the views and the subscribers that some of the big YouTubers have. But, you know,
for the final whistle,
I'm happy to do his thing, and if the day ever comes that, you know, I decide I don't want to do it anymore, I'll make like a final video thanking everyone for their support. Trust me, guys, you'll know when I'm done, but don't worry, it's not gonna be anytime soon. As long as I enjoy doing YouTube, as long as I can do YouTube, I will. So,
he's in a great position there.
Well, that's just a little inside look to YouTube from, you know, just give you guys a heads up of what to expect, or what, from, you know, a standpoint of that I am on YouTube. And this is just aimed to people who are like small channels, but you know, you just think, oh, I'm never going to get that audience. Just keep pumping out the content, and eventually someone might watch. If not, just do it as a hobby, and don't even worry about it. Yeah, hella. And going up to 64 rated, yeah. You only need to go up one more rating. But yeah, just, you know, don't even worry about it. Don't even sweat it. Don't overthink it. Just be yourself. Oh, just... I know some of you think I put on an accent. I don't. I really don't. I don't put on an accent. This is my normal voice. So, those of you who think I put on an American accent, I don't know why I would. Why would I do that? I don't know. I mean, no disrespect to Americans, but why would I put on an American accent? What would that accomplish? I mean, if I ever do become big, and, you know, you guys meet me in real life, you come up to me and you say, hey, is that guy from YouTube? You know, it might be. You come up to me, you ask me if I am who you think I am, and then you hear a different voice. It's just, you think I sound American because when you're recorded, you sound different. You sound different when you record your voice, trust me. I don't sound American normally. If you think I do, that's perfectly okay, but that's not who I am. That's not what I'm about. That's not my thing. I'm not from America. I'm Irish. And this is just how I sound when I'm recorded. I know this for a fact because I've been recorded now a few times. Not just for YouTube. You're probably saying to yourself, not just for YouTube. When the hell are most of you recorded? You'd be surprised how often this shit comes up in, like, college. Like, I recently had to do a recording for a, what's this thing called? An assignment. I had to record like a job thing. Like a pretend job interview. Some of you who are in college will know what I'm talking about. Some of you will probably be like, what the fuck is he even on about? If you don't understand, don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. You know, don't even worry about it. Just, that's just something I often like to say, because you'd be surprised when my comments were enabled, how many times he'd get the, you sound so odd, you sound so vague, you know, speak in your real voice. I've gotten that comment so many times. I'm like, I am speaking in my normal voice. What? I know, I'm sad. And trying to explain to someone, you know, it's more likely that the people who don't understand that I don't sound like an American is probably down to the fact that they've probably never been recorded, you know. And if you haven't, then you've probably just, you know, not been to college yet. Or hell, sometimes some schools will record you for stuff you need to do. I was recorded once in school. Oh, for another 10 job interview. Who actually? It was in my final years. Cool, everyone had to do it. And in my teacher commented that I sounded completely freaking different on the recorder. I'm like, oh, I spoke in my normal voice. You heard me yourself. You were sitting right in front of me. I didn't put on any accent. I'm not speaking with an accent. I don't know what the fuck that is. At this point, I hadn't started YouTube yet. I just was... Yeah, just before I started, actually. But, yeah, it was really odd. It was really odd. But it was actually that inspired for me to say, you know what, let's give YouTube a try as a hobby. So it was then, when I got my... Strong challenge.
Well, he's got away from him. And it's...
In December, I got my hot what I needed, and I got a PlayStation 3 back in the day, a few years ago. Back in the day, I'm like 50 fucking years old or something. When I got the PlayStation 3, I was like, you know what? Let's record it now. This was back when I didn't have an Elgato, so I didn't have the proper way of recording, so the video quality was a bit shit, but I did sound way different than I normally do, and it's not something I'm doing intentionally. It is the fact that you sound different when you're recorded. Some of you will notice, some of you will not, and if you don't notice, now you do. Simple as that, really. I can't put it more plainer than that, ladies and gentlemen. I really can't.
Change of possession here. Pavlyuchenko.
And here comes Abraham. Come on, let's break this deadlock. There we go. Cool. Nothing shut. Finder scored in the last game. Did he? No, he didn't.
It's really exciting, it's really entertaining, and as you've seen, yet again, it's really effective. And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Here's Josh Onema. Could be dangerous. This could be it.
Onema. Slots at home. Beautiful 2-0. Well, just after making it 1-0. Oh, misery compiled.
Well. The touch of a maestro. Just let that ball trundle on into the net.
Yeah, he's having a little chuckle to himself and talking about that, I'm sure, to his teammates.
Well, for Ural, probably absolutely butchering that 100%, no doubt. And, hey, what can you do? What can you do?
There's some potential in this move. Trying to thread it through here. Good slide challenge that.
Really? Regain possession. Is that bullshit serious? He just stuck out his leg and fucking magic. But he takes the ball over. Fucking bullshit. Wanna avoid? Yes! He got by the defender and got the ball away as well. Oh, for God's sake.
Well, that's gone behind. It'll be a corner.
Marino. Onema!
His second goal.
No, I was hoping it would happen. Holy shit! That was not
prepare for that. I fucking looked away. 1 second, I looked away to just check up on my computer's antivirus scan. And fucking, in the Ural player fucking lashes the ball straight to Schreiner's chest. And I can't take advantage of it because I looked away for a split second. For fuck's sake. That's some bullshit.
Is blown to signal the start of the second half. On to the attack now. Well, they've been thwarted here. That's a sign of
get a nice early goal, third goal in this second half. The game just 100% secure the match.
Promising build-up until that challenge. I see a substitute coming on for the away team here. Here's a chance to attack. Makes the challenge here.
He's got a quick mind, this lad.
It's not ideal, but my center back is running at the opposition defense. And go on. At least win the corner, yes! Hey, win the corner!
Well, they're still trailing and they need to do something now if they want to get back into this game. Maybe some fresh legs will do the trick.
We're making a change. Come on. Come on, Linda. Oh, for God's sake.
Building steadily.
With that in Abraham. Yes! Oh! Oh, what an unbelievable look!
The way they moved the ball about there, Martin, before creating the chance was really good. They picked the right pass every time now.
You don't get away with that when you're a goalkeeper at this level.
No, rush of blood, and that's not what you want from your goalkeeper, and it's cost his side.
Given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway. Short passes, but they're keeping the ball. It's a poor touch and the possession's gone away. Well, this attack...
Abraham, come on, make it 4-0. On him again! Wait. I think that's another hat trick. Is it? Does he score a hat trick? I lost complete track of who scored. That might be an Onuma hat trick. It is! Holy shit. Spurs will be fucking delighted that he's scoring this fucking. He is fucking beasting it.
Attacking well here. Shoots. That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper.
Really? Really? You were desperate for that shot, you know? Does that make a difference? It didn't. It really didn't. It made absolutely fucking none. No? Seriously. If you're going to have a shot, come on. What is that, a consolation shot?
Past his man there. Could be dangerous. Real chance. Oh, the striker stopped there.
Oh, for fuck's sake. How lucky was that defender? He tackled me. He looked like he was going to completely miss me, but he fucking.
Danger to the opposition now. They're here, and in he goes with the tackle. That's gone out for a throw-in. Just a change now. He's bringing on a new player.
Making another substitution.
Patience is the name of the game at the moment. Possibly a booking this. Defender to it first.
Win the header.
5 more minutes here.
Mijovic. Onoma. Abraham. Shut. Hi. Hinder. Her. Avoids the defenders as best as he can. Abraham's there. Oh, some bullshit. Hit. There's the full time whistle. Oh.
It was absolutely extraordinary, exceptional, elegant, excellent. Well, he goes across and...
Oh. I have to take a call, so I'm going to just sign off now. Thanks for watching. Home, enjoy. Until next time, you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
There is no doubt that the home side could take the lead, saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch. The break is definitely on. He's had a go here. What a fine save. And here comes the counter-attack. Letting the shot go! This could be it. Gonna try one now. Supporting player alongside.